it's not that button, it is, oh, where's the button? There's the button that makes it record. And so we've got the book here. It has been a long time since we've done a show. The move down here has been kind of distressing. So we took a break. You know, we lost one of our granddaughters at the beginning of the year, and it's just really been kind of hard with everything going on. I mean, missing family, and my mom's not here, my wife's family's not here, my mom and dad are not here, my granny's not here, my daughter, my oldest daughter, my grandbaby, my son, or my oldest son, boy one, boy two, they're not here. So it's been kind of tough. So we just took a little break is all. And so I thought I would come back. Now, I don't know if I'm going to be able to broadcast on Mondays every time, because what I was waiting for was tomorrow and I were going to find out when basketball practice is going to be for the kids. And so tomorrow night we'll find out really when basketball practice is going to be. And then once I know that, it'll be easier, at least for basketball season, to set a night for the show. I do know that everybody has something going on Thursday. It's always something's on Thursday. There's always a practice or something on Thursday. So I've just decided that Thursday. I mean, every time I set it up for Thursday night, it's just been sabotage. So let me get the intro to the YouTube video done. Wait a minute. Hello and welcome to this week's episode of The Artistic Biker Live. How's everybody doing? We've already talked for a little bit, so we're going to skip on over to the book. It has been a long time. I'm out of practice. Hey, peoples! Welcome to this week's episode of The Artistic Biker. Last time on The Artistic Biker, it was self-portrait time. I have no idea how long ago this was. I think it might have been July. I'm not really sure. But we talked about it's not just picking up a pencil, but it's at least picking up a pencil. You have to do a little bit of art every day if you want to get better. You need to be creative every day. And it's not just about picking up a pencil, but it's at least picking up a pencil, doing just a little bit every day. And the book is covered in spider webs and dust and dog hair. It's just been that long since we've done it. Anyway, this week, just before the show, we did a little demonstration about color theory, about color mixing and stuff like that. And so I want to play with that just a little bit in my journal. So with that, let's turn the page and get started. Hopefully there's no spiders, right? Oh, goodness. I think that took some skin. Whew. Okay, we got it open. Let's find us a big brush. And let's get us some gesso about the page here. This book, for those of you unfamiliar, is made of used grocery paper, grocery sacks. Because back in Oklahoma, I had a grocery store just a few blocks from the house that still used paper grocery sacks. And it made it easy to get them. But I find in Houston, since we've moved to Houston, that they are not as prevalent. And I was afraid I was going to have to switch to file folders or something, which I've started with file folders, so I'm okay with that. I thought I was going to have to switch to file folders, but I find that the local liquor store Specs, which are everywhere, has paper sacks that are just the right size. And so I don't need to get anything different. I just need to spend more time and money at the liquor store. Okay, let me dry this and we'll take a little break and we'll be right back. dry enough for our purposes because we're gonna come back in. This is golden gesso grounds, absorbent ground. This is an absorbent ground. After you put a layer of gesso, really you're supposed to put like three or four layers of gesso on. I never do, but usually I'm using kills instead of actual gesso, so I don't know. We'll see how it works. But what this does is we put two coats of this on, and it makes whatever we paint behave like watercolor paper. Make it spread around a little easier. Lubricate the page, if you will. But this stuff, this absorbent ground, makes whatever you paint with it behave. I mean, you could do it, you could watercolor on. We did a demonstration when we first found it. We did a demonstration with a glass bottle. I put some of this on a glass bottle, and I sanded the glass bottle just a little bit to give it to give it a little surface tooth, and then put a little bit of primer on the glass bottle, give it some micro tooth, if you will. And then we put two coats of the absorbent ground on it, and my watercolored on it, and it worked like a charm. Watercolors behaved exactly like you would expect watercolors to behave. It was the coolest thing. But the downside is, especially on a live demonstration like this, is that you have to stop and dry it. Crazy talk. It dries pretty quickly though. That's handy. That it dries so quickly. I don't know that I really want to put another layer on for our purposes. If I were gonna try and archive this, I might. But I think for our purposes, I'll just stick to the one layer. This stuff is cool. I found this stuff. I subscribed to the Golden YouTube channel, and it was just out of the blue. One of the videos they showed. I'm not sponsored by Golden. Golden doesn't provide anything for the show. But hey, Golden, if you're watching, call me. You know, the funny part is I said that, but we're going to edit that part out for the YouTube video, so Golden will never have a chance if they're not watching right now. But I guess the real truth of the matter is if they're not watching right now, it's their loss, right? That's not fair. Again, you know, that's going to be my downfall, is my lack of patience. All right. So, it should behave like watercolor paper now. Okay, Debbie. Thanks for joining when you did. We'll see you later. So, at this point, it should behave like watercolor paper. So, I'm gonna get a bunch of red on here. Bunch of red, bunch of water. You, Dale, I was talking about you. Because I don't see where you said hi. And we're just gonna It's not nearly wet enough, is it? We're just going to spread some of that around. I just want that spread around. I want to leave it. I don't want big puddles, but I want to leave it in puddles in places, and I want it spread around in other places. See how it's soaking in and it's spreading a little bit like it's supposed to on watercolor paper? It's not beading up like it would right on gesso. Let's move over to some blue here. Let's get some blue going. Well, that made some mud real quick because I had some orange spill over into the blue. But that's okay. Oh, there you go. That'll work. This is the background, so we can be kind of messy here. Let's get some yellow. I don't know where we're going to mix the yellow up because I already took the pan that I would normally mix the yellow. Let's just do it over here. Because I don't want as much yellow. That's what I want, right there. Like a charm. Perfect. That's perfect. That's exactly what I want. Because again, this is a background. Probably never see it again. Hi, Kia! I'm going to do the same thing with the green. I'm just going to spatter the green around. You know what? Let's do the green. Let's spatter the green the old-fashioned way. Because this is going to be more of a speckled highlight thing. And we'll do the same thing with some purple. Well, that wasn't purple. That was blue. Then let's get some purple. Yeah, that ground absorbent, look at what it's doing. See how it's absorbing like it's supposed to? That's some pretty cool stuff right there. It lets my purple sit on top of the yellow because the yellow has already been absorbed. And we're not brushing it in. Ooh, look at that mess. I love that. Look at that mess. Let's see. We haven't done any orange. Let's do some orange. Just because we can. Just around the edges, right? We've got this whole, area up here that's unexplored. I don't know how, but paint gets all over everything in my studios. I don't know how this happens. It's the craziest thing. I was watching Dee Dee's stream earlier today, and Dee Dee accidentally stuck her, got her sleeve in her painting that she was working on. And we were laughing because she's, you know, she said all of her clothes have paint on them. And my common answer to that is all of my best clothes, all of my good clothes have paint on them. That's what makes them my good clothes. Okay, so ooh, that camera is not set up for me to stand up because I may or may not be wearing pants. We don't know whether or not I'm wearing pants, but let's set this aside and we'll do what's on your easel. What's on your easel? What's on your easel? What's on your easel today? It's not so much better when the boy does that. We're going to extend this table. And when I extend this table, there'll be room for all three of us. It's one of the reasons why I want to make sure that there's no soccer practice or basketball practice or anything like that on the night that we have the show so that the kids can join us. So 3. Diva Dave posted a picture online of a sunset of a farm that he loved. And I took the liberty of watercoloring it just to get some practice doing sunsets. And the kids have been drawing and painting on cardstock. And my son is probably crazy. Is probably the most crazy prolific thing ever. He gets these notebooks and we go through these notebooks and he's drawn dinosaurs and sharks. Look at these dinosaurs. He's 6. He's drawn dinosaurs. I drew the shark, so. He's 6. Drawn dinosaurs. Long necks, that's a Diplodocus. It's either Diplodocus or Diplodocus, Protoceratops, Paraceralophus. He's 6. He's amazing. And he sits back there in the back seat, Stegosaurus, Pterodactyl. He sits back there in the back seat of the car. He makes up Pokemon, and he's just drawing all the time. And I'm just so proud of him. I don't have any easels sent in, so all I can do is show off what we're doing. I have been working daily. I cannot show you the figure model stuff because Ustream has a an absolutely positively no nudity policy. But I think I can get away with this page. So I do figure practice every day, and I do. In the mornings, I do 10 gestures, 1-minute gestures. In the evenings, I do 10 1-minute gestures. And then I do 5 2-minute gestures, 2 5-minute sketches, 1 10-minute sketch, and then 1 20-minute drawing. And this is the one that I did Christmas Eve. It's the only one that I know. You know, you're working on some faces. It's the only one that I know for sure that I can show you without Ustream banning me. Because they have an absolutely positively no nudity policy. So I can't show you this, but I've been busy since we last broadcast. I have been very busy with my practice, and I'm going to a figure class, and also in the mornings I have been doing the random drawings, the random object drawings, which are the tube toys, like these things that are just toys, but they're from Safari Limited, and they're educational because they're historically accurate. They're anatomically accurate if they're animals. They are, and in the set they are size accurate. Well, that's not true because they have the sperm whale the same size as the blue whale. So I know they're not size accurate, but they are very, very accurate. As a model, and I love them. These little tubes, TOOBS. They're from Safari Limited. I love these little things, dragons. I don't know how, if you could call that historically accurate or not, but anyway, I love the Leaning Tower of Pisa. I love these things. Nefertiti. Is that the Parthenon? I think that's the Parthenon. Anyway, I love these little things, and I have a couple hundred of them. And every morning I just grab one and I draw it at random. Hi, Queen Teen. Every morning, purse, office, skull, cannon. Every morning I just grab one and I draw it at random. And I've been doing it for several months now. Anyway, so that's what has been on my easel. If you would like to, that's what's on my easel. That's what was on their easel. If you would like to be a part of what's on your easel, simply send an email to blade@artisticbiker.com with the subject line easel, and we'll use your work to inspire other people to do some work, because that's what really all of this is all about, is to inspire people to get up and do something. And I don't even care what. I don't care if you're singing. I don't care if you're dancing. I don't care if you're making love. Whatever you're doing creatively, I want pictures. Or it didn't happen. Anyway, that said, this is not quite dry, so I'm going to dry this just a little bit. We will take a little break, and we'll be right back. Normally, especially if this was going to be a foreground, normally I would dry that all the way down, because then you get the hard water lines. Every time it shrinks down a little bit, you get the hard water lines, and it looks like a desert puddle drying up. But I think tonight I'm actually going to sop some of these puddles up, and I don't care if the wet tissue prints somewhere else when I do it. Because, again, this is still background. So, I think that's gonna be fine for us. And then I've got some cardstock. Where's my cardstock? Here, cardstock. Had some cardstock. I found my watercolor paper. I found my acrylic paper. Where's my cardstock? There's my cardstock. I found my cardstock. Oh, thanks, Queen. And then, let's see here. I need to see that. Let's take this. And let's take this. And let's go like this, and like this, and like this. I think I got that exactly backwards. Keep. I did. Oh well, we'll figure it out. Let's cut that out. Bigly. Somebody. Dee Dee was cutting today, and I guess somebody has a problem with scissors making noises. I don't get to watch Dee Dee often because she's on during the day and I have a day job. But seeing as today was a holiday, we call it New Year's Day Observed. Is how it was listed, because New Year's Day fell on a Sunday, and so many of my I work in a retail kind of environment as a day job, and so many of our customers are union oriented that they are required to shut down, that it doesn't make sense for us to remain open either. So we shut down as well. And so I had Friday off for New Year's Eve observed, and then I have today off for New Year's Day observed, and then I have and then I have to go back to work tomorrow, but I don't mind going back to work tomorrow because I've been off forever and I'm tired of being off. I don't know if anybody else has those kinds of problems, but I'm tired of it. Not that I necessarily want to go back to work, but I no longer want to be off work, if you catch my drift. I need some blue. Yeah, that'll work. Make sure we have all the electronics put away. You can't tell, but I have Saran Wrap on practically everything because somehow I get spray paint all over the studio. I don't know how it happens. It's the craziest thing, the way it happens. No, I want that to be there. I'm just gonna tuck that. That'll be fine. Just like that. Might have to put a weight on it. Do I have a weight? I don't think I have a weight. I have a stick though, and I can hold it down. Okay, everybody put your masks on. Wait, what can you see? What can you see? Okay, good, you can't see me. Everybody put your masks on. It's important. It's important that when we do this part of it, you know, for safety's sake, that you have your...
Have a mask on. We'll make sure that you're protected from the overspray and breathing the fumes.
I don't think purple's going to do it. Let's add a little lime green to the mix. Wish I had some blue. Blue'd be really handy. I've got red, I've got white. I have green. No blue. Don't know where the blue is, but I am gonna need that flat black. Make sure I'm running flat black. Woo. I might have to open a door. Hey, if I pass out and die. Oh, we ran Sarah off. I'm sorry. Hey, if I pass out and somebody dial 911. And just keep them on the phone for a few minutes. Just in case. You know? Just in case. Well, that's good tone. All right. Heh. No, seriously, I may have to open a door. All right, what do we have going on here? Let's see. Let's use another piece of cardstock. And let's get some red paint. Now all this stuff piled around my feet is going to mess with me. Try not to pass out. There'll be no CPR tonight, buddy. I don't know. I could use a little CPR. It's been kind of a slow time here at the house. All right, let's see here. We're going to take and we're going to come across here like this. And we're going to do this. And we're going to do this. And then we're going to fan it so that it does that. Just like that. All right. And then we're going to do the same thing on this side. Just like that. And then we're going to take here and we're going to come through here and here and here. Like that. And then we're going to take some of this right across here like this, some of that right across here like this, some of that, and some of that. Come across on this side. Let's see. We need that. But I need that to be thinned out a little. Good, 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 good. And then over here, we're going to come across here. Oop, more paint. Don't start repainting now. We're going to come across there, and then we're going to come across there. And then we're going to come across there. And we're going to thin it. Oop, not thin enough. And we're going to thin it so that we get like that. And then we're going to come out here. Like that, and out here, like that, and we're going to add this, and we're going to add this, and we're going to add this, and then we want feathers, and then we want feathers, and then that's it for the red, and then we want some white. I like to paint in my art journal. A lot of people like to collage. A lot of people like to... That's okay. A lot of people like to do those things. I don't. I like to paint. Let's see, we need this here, like that. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. And then we need this. Let's see, we need this here, like that. We need this. Around here, I've never really been a fan of collage. It's just never been my bailiwick, you know? But I love painting freely. And when I'm done with this, nobody will ever know what this is but me. Which is sad. Okay. This blue dries really dark, so I'm lightening it up a little bit with white, but the white really just dulls it. I don't want it too dull. So but I don't want it so dark that you can't tell it's blue. Which there's some places where I want it really dark. But it just dries. I mean, the way it dries is just way too dark for our purposes. What's he doing? I don't know. I don't know. It's crazy. Whatever it is, it's insane. It's crazy. What in the world, dude? Little heads up before you lose your mind with the paint. Don't you think? Little heads up would have been awesome. Need some green. Where's my green? Let's see. Where's the green that I like? I mean, I could make green, but let's use this green. This is a cool green. Probably have to add some white to it also. I'm not sure what its transparency is like, because this is the student grade stuff from Jerry's Artorama. So I'm not sure what it will be like, but let's find out. Oh yeah, we're gonna add just a little bit of white to it just to give it some opacity. Make it opaque like a snake, right? Perfect. It's perfect. It couldn't have been any better if I'd planned it. What's he doing? I don't know. It's crazy. It's crazy talk. Nobody knows what he's doing. He doesn't even know what he's doing. Making it up as I go along, people. Exactly what I'm doing. Making it up as I go along. Let's get a little white going over here. Let's get just a touch of red in there. It doesn't take much, and a touch of touch of blue. Let's get some violet going right there. Shoot, yeah. A little more blue. A little more red, a little more blue. Oh yeah, there you go. There you go. Let's come across here. Let's do this. Oh, that's much better. And then we get a blue streak. Really dark streak right here. And we'll come around here like this.
Lights out.
Oh, it's bedtime. I love bedtime. Bedtime's one of my favorite times. I don't know about you folks, but I love bedtime. Okay, nobody can tell what that is but me. Let me dry it real quick. It's all right. Travis didn't know what he's missing. It's all right. Okay, I'm going to take this very wet brush. I'm going to thin this blue paint out a lot with this very wet brush. And I'm going to lightly go over this whole area right here. Very lightly. Very lightly go over this whole area right here. You know what? Then I'm going to turn around and I'm going to blue this area up. Because I think it should be bluer. If I'd had blue spray paint, this would not be an issue. We would not be messing with this right now. But I could not find my blue spray paint. And you know what? It's probably right there. I probably tripped on it just a second ago. It's probably right there under my feet, trying to kill me. Okay. I don't know what you're doing, but I like it. So, let's dry it a little bit more. The level of organization around this place, I tell you, it's flat crazy. It's flat crazy. How this cat gets anything done, I have no clue. All right, let's... This is my brush pen. I love my brush pen. Let's start putting some... Let's add some structure to this madness, if you will. I love my brush pen. The thing about a brush pen, this is just a water brush full of ink. When you get... As long as you keep it free of paint. If the acrylic paint gets on it, you have to make sure and wash it off immediately. If you don't, it'll dry on there. And you'll lose the efficacy of your brush pen. The mantis shrimp, if you are unfamiliar, is neither a mantis or a shrimp. It is a crab. It's more closely related to the crabs. And it has, where humans have three or four color sensors, it has 16. And originally, they thought that having 16 color sensors meant that it would be a badass in telling color. And it turns out that that is just not the case. Sadly. It turns out that they have to have all of those different sensors for color because of their depth in the water. The wavelength variance underwater of the colors makes it difficult to differentiate. So where they initially thought that these things would have awesome color vision, turns out they do not. They have no better color vision than we do. Except they have 16 different sensors, right? They have 16 different structures to help them differentiate color. And the reason they have them, though, is because of where they live. It takes 16 different sensors to see the same colors that we do. They see colors, they see in different spectrums. They see the infrared spectrum and they see the ultraviolet spectrum. No, I'm sorry, they do not see. They do, hi Nomadic Rose, they do not see the ultraviolet spectrum. I'm sorry, they do not. They do not see the infrared spectrum. They see the ultraviolet spectrum, but they do not see the infrared spectrum. And that shocked a lot of people, considering the structures that they had for seeing infrared. But it turns out that the reason they had to see that is because that's what it takes to see color at all in the bottom of the ocean. They have about the same colored abilities as a squid. But squids have amazing color abilities. So while it sounds like, oh, well, it's not that impressive, it actually is, because some of the things they can do with their colors is lie. Squid lie. This is not a squid. I'm talking about squid because I think squid are just every bit as interesting as these mantis shrimp. And we're actually talking about color. Squid lie. They use their colors to lie. Oh, that's way too much white. I wonder if I can get some of that back up. They use their colors to lie. Since they use their colors to communicate, they will flash colors to a prospective mate. And another bigger, meaner squid will show up, and on one side of their body they will flash information to the bigger, meaner, badder squid, and they will say, hey, it's all cool. And, you know, these, and they're doing it with color. They're communicating with color. They're submissive. Hey, it's all cool. I'm submissive. I'm not doing anything over here. There's no reason for you to get all red and fiery mad and all that. And they subdue the bigger male. But on the other side of their body that the male, that the other male can't see, towards the female, on the female side of their body, over here, there's a hot chick over here. And on this side, they're like, hey, baby, why don't you get with me as soon as big baddies over here gone? You and I will get together, right? So they're lying on opposite sides of their body because they have that much control over color in the water. And I think that that is wicked cool. I'm going to mess around with this and I'm going to make it where I can't tell where the structures are. Nobody else can either. I'm going to have to give up on it. So, what we started with tonight, we spent the first few minutes talking about why you should do a color wheel and a color grid every time you get new paints. And we ended up painting an animal whose entire life is about color. Except that they thought that he would see billions of colors because he has 12 color receptors where we only have 3 or 4. Can't talk, Harding. All right, calling it down. Actually, I'm not gonna call it down. I wanna do one more thing. This is not near blue enough over here. I'm gonna make this side over here bluer, is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get this blue, I'm gonna thin it. Since I don't have any glaze, I'm gonna hope that it has enough binder in it to let me blue it up like that. And I can dry brush it over here so that it just goes black into the background. All right, I'm calling it done. Let me dry it just a little bit. Okay, as you can tell, nothing fancy is going to happen tonight. This was an experiment in color. There's my matte finish. Where's my satin finish? This gloss white. Oh, I gave a class one time on painting those miniature paintings on playing cards. We all painted on the playing cards, and this one girl painted a feather, and oh, it was a beautiful feather. She did a great job, and she went at the very end, she went to gloss coat over it with clear coat so that it would seal the colors in and seal it to the card and the whole works. But instead of picking up the gloss coat, she picks up the gloss white and spray painted over that sucker. Man, it was heartbreaking. I got a picture of it before she did it, but man, it was heartbreaking because she was like, and she's a high school kid, so you know, just broke her heart. Anyway, so we're going to clear coat this because when you use student grade acrylics, when they dry, a lot of times they lose their luster, but you can clear coat them and it brings the pop back out so that they stay nice and crisp. That, and I felt like my spray paint high was wearing off. Oh my goodness. So let's see. Mantis Shrimp digs your colors. So yeah, we started the night off talking about why you should. We started the night off talking about why you should create these color grid schematic things. Especially when you get new paints, you should go through and you should see how they layer and how they mix, because you need to make sure that you've got you know, because like the blacks will have warm blacks and cool blacks, and you need to make sure you have the, you want to know what you have before you go to tint it, or before you go to change its value. And so we showed different levels of what we did here, how we came up with different reds, how the different reds reacted. Anyway, that led us to painting the mantis shrimp here, because the mantis shrimp sees colors on a whole different level than we do. So it made it fun. Thanks, Dematic Rose. Anyway, that's tonight's gig. I don't know if we're going to stay on Monday nights. I thought that if we moved to Monday nights, that every time they want to do like basketball or soccer practice, it's always Tuesdays and Thursday nights. And on Tuesday nights, I go to figure drawing. I go to figure drawing class now. And session, whatever. But I do that on Tuesday nights. And so I can't miss both practice nights. But now, basketball, tomorrow night we find out when the basketball practice will be. And we're new to the area. Never played basketball with these people. It's at the YMCA. So it'll depend on their coach when the coach is going to be available to teach the kids. And then there's two kids with two coaches, and hopefully they'll want to practice on the same nights. But you know, one's a sixth grader, one's a first grader. So who knows when and where they're going to practice? It may be the two of us running back and forth different directions, and we may end up having to solicit the help of other moms and dads. But in the meantime, until I know when practice is going to be set, it makes it difficult to know when I'm going to be able to stream. But the intention is, again, I have plans to extend this art bench out so that the three of us, girl two and boy two, can sit out here and art with our besties, and we'll set it up. Hopefully the wife can get out here. She's got a table over there. We're going to set her up over there. Don't know if she's going to be able to join us on the show or not, but I'd like to get some teacher updates from the wife too, because I think that'd be pretty cool. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for joining me. You know I look forward to it every week when I do it, because it's been so long. But I love arting with my besties. Anyway, guys, mwah, peace out. Thank you so much. And then we dance until someone says that they see me dancing. I would appreciate it if somebody in the chat room would say that they see me dancing so that I can sign off, because if I sign off before the lag catches up with the chat, then I can cut off like 20 minutes of the video. So Pneumatic Rose is saying goodbye. So does that mean, Rose, does that mean that you see me dancing? Can somebody just let me know? Or are you just saying bye? Oh, I'm going to quit anyway because I'm old. Yeah. All right.